Hello, welcome to this CorelDRAW tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a repeat pattern in CorelDRAW. Here you can see I have developed a textured vector print perfect for sports apparel. I'm going to walk you through the steps required to make this yourself. For this type of print, we'll start by creating some abstract shapes. For this, I'm going to use the freehand tool. I'm going to draw using the tool, making sure that I connect with that first initial point. Then I can head up to Window, Dockers, Properties, choose an outline. So for this, I'm going to choose no outline and a fill type. So uniform fill. And I'm going to choose from the Fashion Home and Color Pantone. So if you're not sure where those are, they are in your spot colors. And I'm going to head down to the blues and greens. Perfect. Now, as we start to draw the next shape, you will notice that it does not remember your fill and your stroke color. So what I would suggest, if you're going to be drawing a lot of similar shapes within your design, and using a lot of similar colors, is that we make sure that nothing is selected. We head back to our color and we change the document default. So every time you click on anything within the properties, whilst you have no object selected, it will ask you if you want to change your document defaults. In this instance, I'm going to say yes, and I'm going to press OK. I'm going to find the color that I want. Perhaps we choose a different color for this one. And then again, confirm that we want that default to change. I also want to change the default. So this is just the document default, just for this document. I'm going to change the outline to none. And again, it's going to ask, I would like to confirm this. And okay, yes, I do. So now when I start to draw with that freehand tool, and ensure that I connect back up at the top, I'm now drawing with no outline and a colored fill, which make things a lot quicker and a lot easier. I'm going to continue to draw a few more shapes, again taking inspiration from your research or your starting point. I choose a new color for this one. Go. Once you've got a few elements to play with, then we can start to look at the textures and effects. Textured print that I'm looking to create, one of the best things to play around with is the effects in CorelDRAW. So I'm going to select a shape, I'm going to head up to effects, and you can see here that we have art strokes. There's a lot of options within that. We also have creative, we have distort, texture, and transform. And within those settings, there are a lot of other settings to tweak and play around with, and you can create some really great results. For this particular print, I'm going to head up to Art Strokes, and I'm going to choose Dabble. Now, if I move this to one side, you can see we have a few style options within Dabble. We've got Sprayed Stroke, Round Stroke, Default Cotton Ball, which is quite nice, Sponge, but I'm interested in the Ice Cube. And I can change the size of the effect, but I like to also randomize, especially if I have a lot of objects to apply this to. I'm quite happy with that, so I'm going to hit OK. I can do the same to the others. Art Strokes, Dabble, move it to one side, randomize, trying to get different scales and different textures happening within this. Maybe let's turn the size up as well as randomize. That's quite nice. And then one more. Effects, Art Strokes, Dabble. Maybe let's go smaller and randomize again. And we start to get some nice things happening. Okay, the thing that elevates this a step further is working with the transparency. So over in properties, I'm going to head to transparency and I'm going to change our mode. So this is something I suggest that you have a play around with, because depending on what is above your object or below and what colors are involved, you will get very different looks. So I'm going to head straight down to multiply, which is one of my favorite ones. And as you can see, it allows the vivid colors underneath to come through without affecting the colors on the original object. There's also things like overlay, hard light, soft light, color dodge. All of these work really nicely. And I'd suggest that you play with them on each object, as they will all have a slightly different effect. And the more you layer these up, the more objects you have, the greater that effect will be. There we go. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a few more elements for my print, and then I'm gonna show you how to turn that into a repeat. Now that we've started to build up a motif of sorts, an area of artwork, let's start to think about how that turns into a repeat print. Start by drawing a square, grabbing the rectangle tool. I'm going to head up to our dimension tools at the top here to make sure that the lock ratio is off. And I'm going to type in a specific object size. So 170. In both boxes. That's the size that I would like my tile to be. I'm also going to make a note of this size for future, because we're going to need it. Let's change the fill color to none, and let's change the outline to black so that we can see what we're working with. We're going to position our design so that we have elements overlapping the top and the left edge of this tile box. So I'm going to select the tile box, send it backwards, send it to the back, and I'm going to move our objects accordingly. You might want to add in some more objects or copy and paste some elements that you already have. Being careful not to overlap the bottom or the right edge, and this will become clear shortly. Now with these overlapping elements, we're going to repeat them so that they overlap on the opposite edge. That's what makes that a seamless tile. To do this, we're going to go up to our object position area. So let's select some objects. Can you see this just here? So the X axis is our left and right axis, and our Y is our up and down. So I'm going to take these two objects here, I'm going to copy and paste them, and I'm going to type into my X axis plus 170. If you remember, 170 was the width of my tile box. So when I press enter, it's going to move the position by the exact right amount of millimeters. So we're going to do that again. We can do that with this selection of objects. So any objects that cross that left side need to be repeated on the right. And any objects that cross the top edge also need to be repeated down below. So again, we're going to copy and paste. And in our X axes, I'm going to put plus 170, press enter, got those moving over. Same with this one here, copy and paste, plus 170. And any objects that cross over this top edge too need to be repeated. So this time I'm going to use the Y axes. And because I'm moving it down, I'm going to press minus. Let's copy and paste that first. I'm going to put minus 170 hit enter, and now we have the correct elements overlapping at the bottom as well. You then need to fill in the rest of your artwork. I've gone ahead and finished the rest of the print design. I've also cut and pasted our tile box so that it sits at the front. I'm going to do that one more time. So I'm going to cut, and then I'm going to select all of my artwork, and I'm going to group those objects. Then I'm going to paste. It will automatically paste in the original position. Then I'm going to select the grouped artwork, head up to Object, down to Power Clip, and place inside frame. Comes up with this little arrow. Going to click inside my tile square, and what it's going to do is click inside that shape and get rid of all of those excess edges that we've had to create in order to do the repeat pattern. And there we have it. We have a perfectly seamless repeat pattern dial ready to add to your apparel drawings. Now it's time for you to give these techniques a try on your own designs in CorelDRAW. To find out more about CorelDRAW Graphics Suite for Business, visit coreldraw.com/learn.